हेलो गाइज, आई एम फ्रॉम गौग्रास मैथ साहब। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 दैट हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 2.1 इन हर ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक फंक्शन एनसीईआरटी 12th मैथ्स। नाउ कम आउट टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 एक्सरसाइज 2.1 इक्वल टू इफ साइन वर्स एक्स इक्वल टू वाई कामा दे हियर फोर ऑप्शंस आर गिवन आउट ऑफ दी फोर ऑप्शन वन ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट। ऑप्शन ए इज 0 लेस देन इक्वल टू वाई लेस देन इक्वल टू पाई B minus pi by 2 less than equal to y less than equal to pi by 2 C 0 less than y less than pi D minus pi by 2 less than y less than pi by 2। Question number 14 I have written like this। Question number 14 exercise 2.1 equal to tan inverse under root 3 minus sec inverse in bracket minus 2 bracket close is equal to ऑप्शन ए पाई, ऑप्शन बी माइनस पाई बाई थ्री, ऑप्शन सी पाई बाई थ्री, ऑप्शन डी टू पाई बाई थ्री। नाउ कम आउट टू सॉल्यूशन हियर। हियर आई एम गोइंग टू राइट सॉल्यूशन 13। हियर यू कैन सी इट इज गिवन इफ साइन वर्स एक्स इक्वल टू वाई। हियर आई शैल राइट इट इज गिवन that sine inverse x equal to y imply that I can write sine y equal to x। So here you can see साइन वर्स एक्स इक्वल टू वाई। तो दिस साइन वर्स विल गो टू द राइट हैंड साइड। हियर इट विल बिकम वाई ओवर साइन वर्स। देन साइन वर्स विल बी पुट बैक टू न्यूमरेटर। इट विल बिकम साइन वाई इक्वल टू एक्स। दिस मीन दैट इंप्लाई दैट एक्स इक्वल टू साइन वाई। एक्स इक्वल टू साइन वाई इट विल बिकम एक्स इक्वल टू साइन वाई। तो हियर यू कैन सी साइन वर्स एक्स इक्वल टू वाई। तो इन प्लेस ऑफ एक्स यू कैन राइट साइन वाई। तो हियर आई शैल राइट इंप्लाई दैट साइन इनवर्स। हियर यू कैन सी साइन वर्स, साइन वर्स here sine verse written, I have written sine verse. In place of x, I can write sine y. So here I can write very well sine y equal to y. Here you can see sine verse in bracket sine y bracket close equal to y. It will become when y belong to close interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2 close interval. This is a concept you must know. Sin inverse in bracket sin y bracket close equal to y. When y belong to close interval minus pi by 2 comma close interval y belong to close interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2 close interval. So this is the case, this is the concept you must know. So here you can see y belong to close interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2 close interval. So you have to, here it can be written, implied that this can be written as like this. Here you can see close interval minus pi by 2, close interval minus pi by 2. this means that minus pi by 2 is included. So here I can write minimum minus pi by 2 will be included. So it can be written less than equal to y less than equal to pi by 2. So here you can see close interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2 close interval. So this means that minus pi by 2 will be minimum, that will be included in the value of y. So hence I have written minus pi by 2 less than equal to y. This means that the value of y will be minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2, y ka value become, because here close interval is given. Similarly, here you can see pi by 2 close interval. This means that value of y will be y equal to minus pi by 2. The same thing I have written here. So you have to judge which option will be correct. So you can see here, this one is not correct. Here you can see minus pi by 2 less than equal to y less than equal to pi by 2. This means that option B is correct. Here you can see less than, but equal to is not there. Here equal to is there. So this means that option B will be correct. So here I can write, therefore, option B is correct. So here you can pick option B is correct. So this is the complete solution of question 13, exercise 2.1, inverse trigonometry function, NCERT third maths. Now come out to question number 14, exercise 2.1. It is given tan inverse under root 3 minus sec inverse in bracket minus 2 bracket close is equal to. Here 4 options are given. Out of these 4 options, one option is correct. You have to decide which option is correct. So let us see solution of question number 14. So here I can write, just I am going to draw here one horizontal line. Here I can write solution of question number 14. Same thing I have written here, equal to. So here you can see tan inverse under root 3 minus sec inverse in bracket minus 2 bracket close equal to. So here I am going to write given that tan inverse under root 3 minus sec inverse in bracket minus 2. This is the question. So here you can see under root 3 is there. So you have to judge under root 3. What about under root 3 here? You have to judge here. So you know better way. Just for rough work here, we can write here rough work here. Rough work, you can write here. Rough work. So you have to judge under root 3. So you know that under root 3 is equal to tan 60 degree. You must know tan 60 degree equal to under root 3. It is correct. So here you can write. Here you can see 60 degree is there in degree. 60 degree will be converted into radian. It will become tan pi by 3. Here you can see pi equal to 180 degree. So 180 degree divided by 3, it will become tan 60 degree. It is okay. So here you can write tan pi by 3 equal to under root 3. So here I can write very well equal to tan inverse in place of under root 3, I can write in bracket tan pi by 3. In place of under root 3, I can write tan pi by 3. So it will become equal to tan inverse in bracket tan pi by 3. Tan pi by 3 equal to under root 3, it will become. So here you can see sec inverse in brackets minus 2 bracket 2. So here I am going to write same thing. Sec inverse in bracket. Now you have to scratch your mind what value R2 will take. So you must know here. You must know very well. This is the rough work. I can erase this one. Now what will do? You have to locate. Here I have written sec inverse in bracket minus 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 is there minus I have written. Here you can see 2 is there. So here you write 2. So you have to show what value of sec will take such that real to outcome will be 2. So you know very well cos 60 degree is equal to 1 over 2. You know cos 60 degree is equal to 1 over 2. Sec 60 degree it will become 2 because inverse of cos will be sec. Cos 60 degree equal to 1 over 2, hence sec 60 degree will become 2. So here you can write 2 equal to sec 60 degree. It is correct. Now you have to assume here 2 equal to sec. Now here you can see 60 degree is there in degree. 60 degree will be converted into radian, it will become pi by 3. Because pi equal to 180 degree, so 180 degree will be divided by 3, it will become 3 6 18, it comes out to be 60 degree. So here you can write sec pi by 3 equal to 2. So here I can write very well sec pi by 3. It is correct. Now come out to here. Same thing I am going to reflect here. So here I can write. Very well. This is the rough work. You can erase here. If this is the rough work. So here I can write very well. Same thing. Tan inverse. In bracket. Tan. Pi by 3. Here same thing I am going to write tan inverse in bracket tan pi by 3. So tan inverse tan pi by 3 I have written. Here I shall write minus. Here you can see sec inverse. Here I shall write sec inverse. In bracket I shall write minus sec pi by 3. I shall write bracket close. Now here you can see tan inverse tan pi by 3. You have to locate. You know, here you have to apply concept. But here, I shall write the same thing here for the time being. Tan inverse in bracket tan pi by 3. I shall write. Here you can see sec inverse in bracket minus sec pi by 3. You know the concept very well. Concept here I am going to write, you might know, CCS rule. You know CCS rule? CCS rule. CCS rule. CCS rule. In this case, this represent cos. This represent cot. This S represents sec. So this represent here cos, this represent here cot, this represent here seek.
This is CCS rule. You must know CCS rule. C cos, C cot, S sec. In this case, you must know cos inverse in bracket minus theta comes out to pi minus cos inverse theta it will become. This is the formula you must know. Next formula you can write cot inverse in bracket. This is the cot inverse I am going to write. Cot inverse in bracket minus theta comes out to pi minus cot inverse theta it will become. This is the theta minus theta you should write. The cot inverse in bracket minus theta bracket close equal to pi minus cot inverse theta. Here you can write sec inverse in bracket minus theta equal to pi minus sec inverse theta. Once again I shall repeat CCS rule. First C represent cos, second C represent here cot, last S represent here sec. Cos inverse in bracket minus theta equal to pi minus cos inverse theta. Cot inverse in bracket minus theta equal to pi minus cot inverse theta. Sec inverse in bracket minus theta equal to pi minus sec inverse theta. This is the concept you must know. Cos, cot, sec. In this case, it will become, I think it is correct, 100% correct. Now in this case, you can write here. Here you can see minus there. Here this minus is there, here I shall minus. Here you can see minus is there. I shall write here minus. Here you can see sec inverse in bracket minus sec pi by 3 bracket close. So in place of here, here I can open big bracket. Here I can open this is square bracket. So this is square bracket I can open. I can write square bracket. I have opened square bracket here. This minus will be reflected here minus. This minus will come back to here. Same thing as minus. Minus, minus. Here I have opened square bracket. Here you can see sec inverse in bracket minus sec pi by 3 bracket close. In place of this term from here to here, you can write very well pi minus sec inverse in bracket sec pi by 3 I can write very well. Like this you can write. Here you can see minus minus. Open here square bracket. Pi minus sec inverse sec pi by 3 it will be. Now come out to next here. Here, this is the concept I am going to erase here. This is the formula you must know. Now what we will do next? Here you can see, just one line once again. Tan inverse tan pi by 3 minus here you can see square bracket opening, square bracket closing. Bracket, square brackets will be broken. This minus will enter inside. It will become minus pi. This minus will multiply together, comes out to plus sec inverse in bracket sec pi by 3 bracket close. Now this is the term you have got here. Now you have to see here tan bar tan pi by 3. So you know the concept here. I am going to write the concept for both cases. I am going to write concept here. Once line we can write here minus pi plus tan inverse in bracket tan pi by 3
प्लस sec इनवर्स sec पाई बाई थ्री. तो हियर यू हैव टू चेक कंसेप्ट्स. दिस थिंग आई एम गोइंग टू रेज हियर, यू मस्ट नो कंसेप्ट. सो व्हाट कंसेप्ट इज सो, आई नो द कंसेप्ट वेरी वेल. टैन इनवर्स इन ब्रैकेट टैन थीटा इक्वल टू थीटा, इट विल बिकम व्हेन थीटा बिलोंग टू ओपन इंटरवल माइनस पाई बाई टू कामा पाई बाई टू ओपन इंटरवल. तो हियर यू कैन सी पाई बाई थ्री. तो हियर यू कैन जज हियर दिस पाई बाई थ्री. तो हियर यू कैन सी टैन इनवर्स टैन इनवर्स टैन टैन, इन प्लेस ऑफ थीटा यू कैन राइट पाई बाई थ्री. तो पाई बाई थ्री, तो हियर थीटा इक्वल टू पाई बाई थ्री, इट विल बिकम. तो हियर यू कैन लोकेट हियर पाई बाई थ्री, द वैल्यू ऑफ पाई बाई थ्री इट विल बिकम 60 डिग्री. 60 डिग्री यू हैव टू सी हियर वेदर 60 डिग्री बिलोंग टू, 60 डिग्री बिलोंग टू ओपन इंटरवल दिस माइनस पाई बाई टू will become minus 90 degree comma or pi by 2 here will become 90 degree. So you can see very well here 60 degree will lie between minus 90 degree comma 90 degree. 60 degree will lie between minus 90 degree and 90 degree. Hence it is proved that tan pi by 3 it will become pi by 3 simply here. और ना चेक दिस वन, चेक नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट हियर. तो हियर नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट यू कैन सी की हियर सेक इनवर्स सेक पाई बाय थ्री, सेक पाई बाय थ्री यू हैव टू लुक इट, सेक इनवर्स सेक पाई बाय थ्री इट विल बिकम इक्वल टू पाई बाय थ्री इट विल बी कम. हियर यू कैन सी सेक इनवर्स इन ब्रैकेट सेक पाई बाय थ्री ब्रैकेट क्लोज इक्वल टू पाई बाय थ्री इट विल बी कम व्हेन पाई बाय थ्री बिलोंग टू. हियर यू कैन सी सेक इनवर्स देयर, सेक इनवर्स इट विल टेक कॉस, cos it will take. So now here I shall take range of cos. So here I can write very well close interval 0 comma pi. You must remember close interval 0 comma pi, 0 comma pi close interval minus here you can see sec inverse. So here I can write very well in curly bracket pi by 2. Why pi by 3? Why pi by 2 will be written? This is the concept you must remember. Why pi by 2 will be written? Because in case of sec, the sec pi by 2, sec pi by 2 comes out to sec 90 degree. Do you know cos 90 degree is equal to 0? Cos 90 degree is equal to 0, the sec 90 degree, it will become infinite. That's why term related to infinite will be excluded. That's why I have excluded this term. Pi by 2, I have excluded here. So here you can see pi by 3. The pi by 3 comes out to 180 upon 360 degree. The 60 degree will very well lie between close interval 0 comma pi. Hence this sec inverse sec pi by 3 it will become pi by 3 simply. So here you can write, this is the concept I have written here. So here you can write, now come out to question here. The question you can see here, this is the concept you must remember, this is the concept I you must know, this is the concept I am going to write in the box, this is the concept you must know very well. This is the concept. Concept just over this the pi, pi by this. Okay.
This is the concept. So here you can see this one. But if I here sec inverse in bracket sec pi by 3, it will come pi by 3. Here tan inverse tan pi by 3, it will become pi by 3. So you know very well, here I can write minus pi plus tan inverse tan pi by 3 equal to pi by 3, it will become, because criteria or concept is being verified here. You can see from here to here it is being verified. So here I can write tan inverse tan pi by 3, it will become pi by 3. Now here you can say sec inverse sec pi by 3, it will become pi by 3 again. Pi by 3, I can write pi by 3. Why pi by 3? You can see, this is the concept. Sec inverse sec pi by 3 equal to pi by 3. So I have taken pi by 3. Pi by 3 means 60 degree. The 60 degree will lie between 0 and 180 degree, where 90 degree is excluded here. So in this case, it will become. So here you can write very well, minus pi plus, here you can see 3, 3. So you will take 3, 3 there. You will take LCM 3. So it will become 2 pi by 3. It will become 2 pi by 3. You can write very well 2 pi by 3. Here you can write 1. The 1 you can write. So this will become, here you can see 1. Here you can see 3. So take LCM of 1 and 3. It comes out to LCM will be 3. So here you can write 3. Here you can see 1. The 1 will be multiplied to 3. The minus pi will also multiply by 3. So here you can write very well. Minus 1 will multiply to 3. The pi will also multiply to 3. The minus 3 pi. Minus 3 pi I shall write plus 2 pi I shall write. It will become equal to minus 3 pi plus 2 pi. Comes out to minus pi. Minus pi over 3. This will be the correct answer. The answer will be minus pi by 3. Hence you can write option B. You can see here option A, pi. Option B, minus pi by 3. Option C, pi by 3. Option D, 2 pi by 3. So you can see here option B, minus pi by 3 will be the correct answer. So here I can write very well. So option B equal to minus pi by 3 is correct answer. Is the correct answer. So here you can see option B, minus pi by 3. You can see here minus pi by 3 I have written. So minus pi by 3, option B will be the correct answer. So this is the complete solution.